Duophony by GFI. All right, I'm going to warn you up front that the only thing that I haven't figured out about this pedal so far is how to pronounce it. So throughout the video, we're going to jump back and forth between Duophony and Duophony. I think it might be Duophony, but I kind of like Duophony, so you're going to hear some back and forth on that one. So despite not knowing how to pronounce what this is, I do want to talk about what this is. The Duophony is a parallel signal blender, but above and beyond any other parallel signal blender I've used. What makes this so special is a couple of things. Number one, and this is the one that is the most important to me, it's in stereo. So you have two stereo loops, one on each side, allowing you to run your stereo delay and reverb in parallel, allowing you to blend between different entire effects chains if that's something that you want to do. Or in my case, blending direct rig amplifiers together. We'll come back to that in a second. This thing can also do a myriad of other more ambitious, crazy things. You can switch between parallel and series modes, basically running your X and Y loops parallel alongside one another, or running X into Y or vice versa. You have the ability to change the way that your parallel blending works. You can have it be a kind of balance, like 100% total balance between X and Y, or one of them is always at full strength and you are blending the other one in to meet it. You have things like polarity reverse, which again, we will come back to why that's so important. You have presets, you have MIDI, you have flexible routing, and most impressively, you have an LFO built into this thing. And so that what that means is you can apply a MIDI clockable tap-based LFO of any subdivision you want in a myriad of different waveforms to a low frequency oscillator that will kind of like automate the blend between your two loops or the dry signal you have, basically allowing you to hands-free blend between your effects, or in some situations, basically create MIDI clocked faux tremolo systems out of this thing. Now you might be asking what the value of some of those things is. When this first showed up here at my studio, I took one look at that LFO thing and kind of went, never gonna use that. I don't understand why I would want to automate the balance between my like delay and reverb, for example, in a wet, dry, wet rig in something like this. However, on that intro song, you heard that really kind of weird, esoteric, sound designy ambient stuff that kind of was at the top of the track and permeated throughout the middle of the track. What that was the Hologram Microcosm and the Meris LVX both set full wet as like these really bizarre soundscapey ambient patches that I've made, blending back and forth automatically inside of this thing, basically allowing you to create ever-evolving ambient soundscapes with this kind of expanding and blowing out the possibilities of your already incredibly like effective and powerful wet effects. But honestly, you don't have to go super high-minded about something like this to get a lot of value out of it. For me, I've been using this since the day it arrived at the studio, and I've been using it on all of my videos here in the studio, and you just haven't known because I haven't shown it on camera. But what I have used this for basically every day since it arrived is blending my Universal Audio Ruby and Dream amp pedals together. I'm a massive fan of both of those amplifiers and spent a long time running them left channel, right channel. I have found that I really prefer wiring them both up in full stereo and then blending between the two. And this allows me to keep both of them at the end of my signal chain and to kind of flexibly move between all Vox style amplifier, all Fender style amplifier, or any blend between the two. And what I have found is I tend to run kind of an 80-20 split of AC30 and Fender, a little bit of that low end presence from the Fender amp, and a lot of that bite and clarity from the AC30 style amp model. And if you use those amplifiers, you may know they are out of polarity with one another. If you plug them both in and run them at the same time, you will get phase issues. This allows you to flip phase on one side, solving for your phase issues internally in this one device. Again, the applications here are pretty much only limited by what you can kind of envision wanting to do with something like this. You can MIDI clock that LFO. You can use your MIDI controller to pull up presets on this thing. You can assign expression pedal controls into the side of this thing to sweep your blend between your two channels, or to bring in and take out your dry signal. And it's all done pretty simply with an A and a B foot switch down here to switch between what preset you're on and the ability to kind of press them both to bank between. And then up top, you have your gain controls for your two loops. And then in here in this center area, this is actually all touchscreen, which you will see in our sound samples. But you can just kind of sweep along this with your finger to set your levels and your blends where you want them to be. Having said that, it's a little finicky. I find that it takes me between 1 and 3 tries on any given time to get my positioning where I want it to be. I mean, it's a touchscreen guitar pedal. How much accuracy do you really want out of that? And if that's my biggest gripe about this thing, which in earnest it is, my biggest gripe here is kind of a flubby touchscreen experience, that is nothing to really scoff about in my opinion. There's so much to love about this thing. Like I said, I've been using it every day since it came in, just at the most base level. So what I want to do now is jump into our sound samples, which we are going to divide up into 3 different sections, getting progressively more elaborate as we go. Section 1 is going to be my idealized use case, that day one usefulness factor for me, which is stereo parallel amp models in the Duophony. We're doing it again. So we're going to run through my full pedal board and then an auxiliary pedal board at the end of everything with the Universal Audio Ruby and Dream on it. this guy managing the two of them and then running to a DI. We'll take a look at blending between the two and kind of how I set up my tone for different applications with some sound samples for that. So we have our Ruby and our Dream wired up in stereo here, not left, right, mono each, but properly stereo and hard pan for both of them. So like the Ruby is currently, because we have a full green ring here, this is all Ruby. But if you turn on like a delay, you will hear that stereo image still. Okay, so now we jump over to, we go along this touch slider and go to there, and now we're at 100% the Fender side. But what I love here is traditionally with real amplifiers or with most wet dry blend things like, or a parallel blending like this, you would end up with a 50-50 with this on one side, this on the other side. And here you can get them mixed in the center, which is amazing. But for me, the thing that I find so useful here is the ability to go anywhere in that mix. So my standard go-to thing is I like the clarity and the bite and the cut and everything on the Ruby, especially with some like rhythm stuff or with some like drive and some gain. So let's give it a little bit of a plate reverb. So you kick on something like the Del Mar and... I like the way that that breaks up and the way that fits into a mix a lot more than I would like all of this. Sounds great. It's got better low-end response, but it doesn't have all of that clarity I need against something like... But AC30s don't often have all the low end you would want. So the beauty here, and what I typically have this set as, is just bringing in about 20%. And now you have all of that clarity and all of that articulation of the AC30. But you have it with that little bit of low end and roundness that you get from a good Fender style amp. Something like the Blackmass 1312 is a great example of why you would want something like this. There we go. Because a rat style pedal is often going to kind of like compromise some of your low end a little bit. And being able to bring that in is a lifesaver. Especially if you're doing like some of my favorite kind of like rat motifs, like split octave lead parts. Yeah, that little bit of added energy with that low end is key and crucial. So this has been a staple. This board has stayed basically arranged like this for weeks now for this exact reason. So next up, let's go ahead and take a look at how you wire this up for a wet, dry, wet rig. We are going to use the Strymon Dig, the Neunaber Illumine, and the Duophony into the Universal Audio Woodrow amplifier. We'll take a look at the different ways in which you can run series and parallel. We'll look at the couple different ways that you can do blending between your X and Y sends, as well as how to set your kind of overall gain structure inside the pedal for your wet effects and bringing in that dry through send to get your clean channel and your clean tone on through to your amplifier. Okay, so we are running carbon into the Duophony, into the Woodrow with the Strymon Dig and the Neunaber Illumine in our left and right sides of the pedal for a wet, dry, wet rig. This is with the pedal bypassed. And before we get into it, it's worth noting, if you're running stereo into the front of this, you want to be sending stereo and stereo on your sends to these pedals. But for the purposes of what I'm doing here, I'm running mono into the front of the pedal, and you want to send mono to each of these and stereo returns on each of them, or else you're going to find yourself not getting your full image. And we'll give an example of that really quick. We have all dig right now on the mix. No reverb because we are all green, which means we're all this side, this channel, and no dry through going right now, which sounds like this. But if I was running the dig in stereo, I am technically using a TRS cable over here. But if I have this thing set up to take stereo input, you're going to get this. Because even though I am sending a TRS cable over this, I'm only getting a left input, a mono input over here, and it's sending on the left channel of the TRS. So jump over to that or use a TS standard mono cable and you will end up with. And then we can sweep through this, introduce some of our reverb or all of our reverb. Let's find a nice balance there. Let's go 50-50 to start things off. Whoops. Let's go 50-50 to start things off. Come on. Let's go ahead and dial in a blend of the two. So we want to go ahead and let's go with kind of largely delay with a little bit of a bed of reverb to support things. We'll even go a little bit, let's keep it about there. And then what you want to do now is hit this thing at the bottom and jump over and bring in your dry signal. So as you can hear now, we're getting our dry signal and then our delay unaffected by reverb and vice versa. What's really nice though is if you're using something like the Illumine where I have it at mix, the wet mix at 100%, but no dry kill enabled, that might be a little overwhelming. Or the wet effects might, in general might be overwhelming. So what you can do now is take the gain controls up here and gain down your delay and your reverb to let your dry signal sit out on top of the mix a little bit more presently. I mean, you could leave this at like a 50-50 mix between the two and just gain down whichever side you need less of. And you can also boost from these as well, which is really useful if you have, like I said, wet effects that don't have a dry taper to them or a kill dry to them, or if you're using something that tends to kind of gain up or down more than you would like it to in a kind of like traditional signal chain. Take them back to 5 and 5. Okay, but there are two other modes of mixing here for your X and Y send and returns. We are currently in the XY mix, where as you kind of sweep through here, we get all reverb, all delay, but as you go through it, you start to lose one or the other. On one other note on this XY blending and just kind of blending the two in general, you can always click on one of these to mute that side. Useful for momentary changes or for just making sure that you're kind of checking your work along the way, making sure that like the delay repeats are kind of like lasting as long as you want them to. And then just bring it back in rather than having to like mess with your mix if you've got it dialed. Which is really great. So, but like we said, we've been dealing in a kind of this and that blending situation here. By holding down this gain X side, we can enter the kind of like preset specific options, go into our modes and go from XY to Y plus X, which will basically put us in a position where we have all of our delay all the time. And as you sweep, it starts to introduce more of that reverb, but without decreasing your delay. So as you can see, the X side never leaves 100, but you can bring the reverb up to match. That's really helpful if you want to kind of get all of everything, or assigning an expression pedal to sweep through this balance. And so instead of sweeping out your delay, you can sweep in your reverb or in your delay whenever you want to. So yeah, and then you can instead jump from series to, or from parallel to series. So now you're hearing those delay hits are going into that reverb. And that is, of course, order switchable as well. Okay, lastly, let's get really ambitious with some stuff. Let's go ahead and rewire that board back up, replacing those easier wet effects with some really esoteric things. We're going to use the Microcosm and the LVX, full wet on both of them, going full sound design, synthy nonsense. And this is where we're going to introduce those LFOs and the different ways you can assign that to create some really interesting, evolving textures. So we have set up now is the Microcosm in the Y send and return and the LVX by Meris in the X. We're going to ignore our dry signal. So we're going to run them in parallel with no dry signal. Here's our quick dry refresher. Okay, let's get into it. We have my shallower patch and the Microcosm. Let's start things off with the shallower, which is going to be an like octave reverby washed out version of like a shallow water thing that I made for this. And on the other side, you have a kind of classic like octave-y sequence-y thing that I really like. Let's boost the Moth up a little bit. There we go. Okay, so obviously starting things off, you can do the easy normal thing, which is blend them. But now let's get into what really sets this thing apart from any other stereo parallel blending options, of which there are already exceedingly few. By holding down and twisting this gain X side, we go into, here we'll do that so you can see the screen. You see that we now have a modulate on and off thing. If we jump to on, we can decide if we want it to be parallel or normal, panning or normal, and then we can pick a waveform. So let's start with normal and a sine wave. So what that's going to sound like is, let's hit okay. Now you are going to see that light flashing and you can set your tempo, your subdivision, all that stuff. And that is just automatically blending back and forth between these two devices. And within that world, you can also change that waveform to something like a ramping up or ramping down sawtooth kind of thing. Bunch of waveforms for you to choose between, which is really cool. But what I really like about this thing is the ability to do that panning thing. So instead of just XYing, they switch positions on the left and right channels back and forth. And the wild thing about that is, if we bring in that that dry signal, you can hear what I'm actually playing alongside all this. You take that back out, all that dry signal, come on. There we go. You take all that dry signal back out, and you just end up with this incredible... Let's jump in my LVX up to one of my string patches that I really like. Let's go to one of the sawtooths for this like panning thing. And of course, if we return back to that normal, just some of the coolest sound design stuff you could kind of pull together from the gear you have. This unlocks things that these things can't do on their own, despite being two of the most powerful pedals I own. Okay, so one final thing we're gonna do here. Let's go into our modes. Let's go to X plus Y. So hit confirm on that. And now we're back out. This is going to be our consistent fixture. Whereas if we mute that and unmute the LVX, you can hear that that's being modulated in and out alongside a consistent version of the Microcosm. So we can actually now bring the Microcosm back in, and now you will get consistent response from this and an LFO guided version of the vinyl strings. Let's gain down those strings a little bit. Mm-hmm. Or let's even go something like, let's go with that glide. I'm such a huge fan of the glide mode on the Microcosm. Let's pick a better shape. Let's go with one of these like really stuttery, this only sometimes comes in. Yeah, this thing is insane. Thank you so much for watching. If you made it to the end here, thank you for sticking it out. If you want to hit the like button, maybe subscribe to the channel if you're not already. I never do calls to action like that, so I guess I'm just going to put it at the very tail end of a long video so that as few people as possible see it. If you want to know more about the Duophony, whatever, I'm going to put a link to GFI's website down in the description down below. Again, this is great if you need a compact wet, dry, wet solution, a way to switch between full signal chains quickly, or some sort of MIDI capable way of blending between your amplifiers. Until next time, thanks for watching.